up your right hand to God right now. Then you open up your spirit and let God begin to work through your heart. Talk to him right now for the very moment that you are about to hear his didactics, his teachings, that will make you wiser than you have ever been. Before you enter into the sanctuary of his glory, begin to believe you right now to open your ears. Bible says that last days they will be suffering from a disease called itching ear syndrome. They will be heaping upon themselves teachers. They will be seeking for their own desires. Apostle Paul told Timothy, pray. Make sure you do not compromise. Because in the last days, men shall be lovers of money, lovers of themselves, unthankful. But you are standing here in the name of Jesus, and you are standing here as a child of God, knowing that your name is written in the Lamb's book of life, and that you are going to heaven. Pray right now. Dedicate yourself to God again. Dedicate your spirit, your soul, and your body into the hands of the Holy Spirit, so that whatever is going to be said today, you will benefit from that. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lenda Rama Sutayande. Le Prakata Sutayande. Lende Rama Sutayande. Le Barama Sutayande. Is brought under the auspices of the Holy Ghost. The whole atmosphere is brought under the power of God. And every spirit that is son of God, I summon you to be bound, to be chained. Every witchcraft spirit, necromancer, divination, warlock, wizards, powers of darkness, I bring you exposed and disgraced. I'm saying that in this case, we have to understand, a demon possessed man or woman, a demon possessed girl or boy, a demon possessed family member, your mother or your father or your siblings, you are not supposed, even if you know that she's a witch and he's a wizard, you are not supposed, as a born again Christian, to begin to execute divine violence on them in the presence of God, that God should annihilate them physically. That is not your business. Say amen, somebody. Amen. Because some of these demons or evil spirits I'm talking about, they possess our human families without even they having authority over it. Now, I have made you to understand that this is your... Now, let me get a little 3 points here and leave you to go home in peace. No, not in pieces. Listen very carefully. The women, the two of them, spoke about what? Spiritual marriage. And this is a serious problem with many men and many women. In that sense, the spiritual marriage, we are dealing with what? An evil spirit. Two of them we know that love to have sexual intercourse with men and women when they sleep. Incubus. Succubus. If you go to your dictionary, English dictionary, not Bible, dictionary, open incubus, you'll find it. Even they know it already. Before even we talk about it. But these are demonic spirits. These are demonic agents. The incubus are sent as male demon spirits that come to girls, especially girls and women. When they sleep, they come to them and have sex with them. At a very tender age, they start. Especially those that were initiated to idols and shrine in Africa. Or if the door was opened by the parent to allow that spirit to come in. This spirit will always visit them. And when you are younger and you have this visitation and you don't deal with it early, you will grow. It is a spirit that will say he has married you. And therefore, when they have a relationship with you, you will never enjoy having a relationship with your natural husband. Never. They will induce you and seduce you so much that natural affection will never exist. You will break your mind 100 times. until these demons are what? Are removed. They trouble you, they fight you in ministry, house, money, no peace. The man said, Pastor, we could not rest. I mean, even in the boxing, even Muhammad Ali and Tyson, when they fight, what about, they give them time to rest, is that right? But then they have to go to the corner. After him, his house, no rest. Until that deliverance. These spirits are stubborn. And sometimes when you marry a woman with the incubus, in fact, money in the family never come. I mean, object poverty, hardships, difficulty, business cannot flourish. Not because they are stubborn spirit, and the envy of the demon is that, why must you marry my wife? So this male demon, who thinks he's the husband of your wife, is making what error trace. And he will make sure he will impoverish the whole house until the marriage is broken so that he can take full possession. The men also have another one called succubus. Incubus for the women, succubus for those women, not in this church, but others. And the succubus also sleep with men, and their men also, they have wet dreams. When they go to bed, they sleep, a woman is sleeping with them, and real. They have wet dreams all the time. And this spirit also claims that they are what? Wives. Most of them, as you have studied and researched, they come from the marine kingdom. Most of the succubus, they come from the marine kingdom, and they like to dominate. And equally the same thing, if most of the time, what happens is that if the men have the succubus, women, the wives, suffer from fibroids. It's known, fibroids can be there, but this spirit, most of the day, cause that. If you are sleeping with a man that is having that spiritual dreams or intercourse with the spirit, the woman always receives fibro, and sometimes it can make her barren. Because these spirits are envious, very jealous, and they claim him to be a husband. They don't want their natural wife to be productive. So problems, only to do to split them. And now when this one goes on for a long time, it will affect the whole family. Sometimes children will be born, but then there's no peace in the house. Because these spirits have not been dealt with. They will fight, and what I think they do quite often is the financial area. Anger, fighting, and money problem. Anger, fighting is the basic ones. So showing this example is that when you are going through these things, must you still pray that the woman should die? No. It is let us go beyond the natural. Understand that there are all spiritual forces that are causing problems in our human world. So my dad, we cannot stay here today in the 21st century, New Testament Christian, and then we want to kill all our fathers and our mothers and brothers and sisters and the wives. No, that can't work. Then nobody will be here. Because you kill someone, somebody else is going to kill you tomorrow. So what is important for us is that natural execution is not given to us. Unless God himself wants to do it, he will do it just as he did it in the days of Peter when Ananias and Sapphira fell down in the crusade ground and they died. God can do it because he said, I am the Lord God. I can kill, I can make alive, I can make poor, I can make rich. God can do whatever he wants to do, but it's not your duty. Bible says, vengeance belongs to me. It's not you to revenge. You can pray and commit the person who is troubling you into the hands of God, but you don't pray that the person should die. Rather, pray that the demons trouble him or using him to trouble you or help trouble you. Let the demon be bound and be cast out and be caged perpetually. You can pray dangerous prayers because the Bible said the weapons of warfare, they are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. And we are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against what? Principalities and powers. The rulers of the darkness of this world and the spiritual host of wickedness in the heavenly places, celestial spirits, marine forces, terrestrial and underworld. They are our enemies we are fighting against. So human beings don't come, but they are human beings who have joined in the evil forces together that they will do evil. God handles them. If God says separate, they don't separate. God can destroy them all. But that's not our duty. Our role is to pray for her, his defense and protection. And that's why I try to make sure I enlighten you. Because there's an authority in the spiritual realm where you can execute some things. But not every ordinary Christian, you just pick up and because you don't understand, you want to kill. And so some of you will end up killing your wives. Some of you will end up killing your husbands. Because some of you are here, we don't know what you're going through. And you really want God to give you a solution. If your husband is molesting you, beating you, harassing you, taking your money from you, or your wife is beating you like what you saw over here, automatically you want a solution. And sometimes after you struggle for years, 3, 4, 5 years, that you think is enough. There are many women. So I can, this one can go, I can go another one. Oh, there are many men. So you want the other one to die. And I have seen, some men of God who I know, when they pray, they want to pray that their wife should die because the wife was troubling them. And they didn't want to let it be like the divorce, because people will see that, oh, why divorce? So if the woman is dead, then it's okay for them to go to the next one. I have no men of God, I respect them, highly men of God, I know that had a situation. That they were praying. They even called other men of God to join them, so they would pray. So that, and the one who ran away was the one who told me, say, Pastor, I can't join that team. I mean, serious matters. Say, let's pray, because the woman was troubling him too much. She said, let her go and rest. Where? In heaven. So I can have my peace in ministry. Yeah, because things are not moving. See this strong man, the one from Nigeria, tough man, but he said she beat me well. Can you imagine? I don't know. I mean, even he reduced himself to be the woman. He said, you be the man. Even what God said, the man should be the head. He decided to let the word of God stay away. God, keep your word. I'm the woman. You see, so this man could do anything. But I respect his patience and wisdom, and that we can learn from. Somebody say amen. Yes. Understand that this is the reason why if we don't do that one, we'll go about destroying the body. Now ask your neighbor, if that one happened to you, what will you do? Ask your neighbor. I mean, to be real, because some of you have your brothers and sisters that have robbed you. You sent all your money for them to build a house. After they finish the house, they even use their name to build a house. They won't give you the land, the house again. You think, man, I must revenge. There are some of you have done so much for your sisters. They have abused you. You don't know what to do. They don't even respect you. You better think you want to revenge. There are many things going on in families. But if you want to focus on what they are doing, you will kill them. So right now, what we're going to do is that we'll kill the spirit. We bind the spirit and what? We release our blood. Because yesterday we saw one, and then the next time we saw a new change. It means if you are here, I'm close to you now, and you have any human enemy who is troubling you, this person took your money from you, this person took this, in fact, you really want to have a peace, stand up with me right now.